Good evening to all my brothers and sisters around the world. How was your day? It's reflection time. It's reflection at bedtime. Another half an hour of devotion where we will reflect on the goodness of God again today. Now, today's our second day, and I am so grateful for everyone that joined me last evening and has expressed that they were blessed. And so this evening, I pray that whatever we discuss will bring a blessing to you and be an encouragement to you as well. And so I have received some prayer requests, and we will be praying over your requests as promised. And we will continue to pray for you, because we know that when the family prays together, they will stay together, and this family will stay together in prayer. So welcome again to another evening reflection at bedtime. Let's have a word of prayer. Gracious God, we're so thankful for the blessings of this day. You have kept us throughout the night. You have awoken us up in our right minds. You got us on our way. You granted us favor and mercy that brought us to this moment at the close of another day. The day has dawned and history was made, because what happened today may never be repeated. And so, Lord, we thank you for your goodness towards us, for protecting us as we traveled to and from, for giving us the wonderful things of nature that still spells how great our Creator is. So we thank you for providing, supplying our needs, for making a way when it seemed like there was no way, for answering prayers. Oh God, we thank you. And so bless us as we go through tonight. May everyone that tune in receive a rich blessing from your throne room. And we thank you for forgiving us and for accepting our praise and our prayers right now, because we ask them in the worthy and the most precious name of Jesus. Again, I want to welcome all to our Reflections at Bedtime devotional. And right now we're going to listen to a song. You know, this weekend is considered the Easter weekend, and so today is called, it's not biblical, but it's called Good Friday. And so our little devotional thought is entitled, What's Good About That Friday? I will share that with you in a little bit, but before I do that, I would love for us to listen to this song. I surrender all.
surrender humbly at His feet.
To Jesus, I surrender. I was blessed. I hope you are too. Amen. Amen. And moving on, we will have a testimony from a dear sister. She tuned in yesterday and she wanted to share her testimony with us about the goodness of God and what's going on with her in her life. So let's listen to our sister as she express and share with us what God has done for her or what's going on with her life that she wants to give God praise for. Let's listen.
Hi, Sister Kim. Thanks for having me on. Thanks for having me on Reflections at Bedtime. So, oh my God, let me tell you. So, today, as always, I got out of bed. Before I got out of bed, I'm sorry, I rolled over and I began to thank God for waking me up because I know that a lot of people, you know, don't get the opportunity to wake up and see another day. And so I'm always, you know, grateful and I give thanks for that. What I didn't know was that the enemy had a trap set for me. I literally end up dealing with several people trying to bully me. And yes, I'm a grown woman, and no, don't get it confused. No matter what age you are, you can still deal with bullying. And I just thank God that I'm not the person that I used to be, the person that would just jump into defense mode and, you know, feel the need to want to, you know, fight a battle that, you know, is not meant for me to fight or whatever. Because now, having my relationship be stronger with God, I'm realizing that it's better to let Him fight my battles for me, and that's what I did. I literally didn't give in to the situation. I allowed God to step right in and handle it, and because I did, He sent people in, you know, to come and literally deal with the bullies and handle the bullies for me, and he not only did that, but in the midst of the whole situation, I end up fellowshipping and getting amazing prayer with even a stranger about the situation. And so I just shout out to you, by the way, if you do end up seeing me here on Reflections at Bedtime with Sister Kim. It really meant a lot, those encouraging words and you praying with me. And I really, really, really thank you so much for that. But yes, when you know who you are, when you know who you belong to, when you know how powerful and mighty the God is that you serve, no matter what comes your way, you know that you don't gotta flinch, because again, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. And so, you know, with that being said and done, you know, I had to realize that, you know, hey, even as a child of God, you're going to go through some things, and no matter what you go through, you got to realize, listen, you can't have a testimony without having some tests or whatever. And so this is my reflection for today, and I am so grateful and so thankful, you know, Sister Kim, that you would have me to come on and share this reflection for today with you all. Thank you so much, and you all be blessed. Bye.
Thank you so much, my sister, and I'm so grateful for the goodness of God in your life. Let's continue to pray for our sister and her situation, that God will work everything out according to his will and plan for her life. And so at this time, I want to share or devotional thought with you. And as I mentioned before, the title of it is What's Good About That Friday. Lord, bless your word to hearts that are listening, and we thank you for your message in Jesus' name. What's good about that Friday? That beautiful record of the crucifixion week of Jesus is recorded in Mark chapter 15. That's Mark chapter 15, and you can read that for your own pleasure. I'm going to pick up the story from verse 8, and it says, Then the multitude crying aloud began to ask him to do just as he had done always. But Pilate answered them, saying, Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews? For he knew that the chief priests had handed him over because of envy. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd so that he should rather release Barabbas to them. Pilate answered and said to them, What then do you want me to do with him whom you call King of the Jews? So they cried out loud again, Crucify him, crucify him. Then Pilate said to them, Why, what evil has he done? But they cried out all the more, Crucify him. So Pilate wanted to gratify the crowd, releasing Barabbas to them, and he delivered Jesus after they had scourged him and crucified him. Have mercy upon us, O Lord. We thank God for the sacrifice of Jesus, but can you just a little bit even think of what Jesus went through for your sake and for mine? This is a story that it doesn't matter how many times you go through it. It's so hard to understand why he did what he did. But that four-letter word, L-O-V-E, it's because of God's love. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. That's the reason why that was a Good Friday. because he wanted his children to have eternal life. So he bought back our salvation on that Friday. Thank God that it was a good Friday. The crowd shouted for Barabbas. He was a thief, a murderer. He did not worth anything. But the King of Kings, that is all in all to us, he was the one that was crucified. Barabbas was set free. Jesus did what he did to set us free, because we are the ones in need of a Savior. I thank God for that Good Friday. Jesus was that person that said, "If it's your will, O Lord, O my God, if it's your will, let this cup pass from me." It was a heavy burden for him to bear, but he took my place. He took your place, and that's why it was a Good Friday. I like to take the positive out of every negative. So when the enemy thought that he had won the victory on that day, Jesus is and was at that time the winner man. He meant bad, but God meant good. So it was a Good Friday. It was the plan of redemption from creation. God planned this to save you and to save me. What a Good Friday that was. When Jesus cried out in verse 34, it was the ninth hour, and Jesus cried out with a loud voice saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," which being translated, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Jesus felt alone. He felt as if he was not loved. But then he remembered, as he gave up the ghost, he asked for the forgiveness of those who crucified him. "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they have done." So he suffered, bled and died, took my place, took your place to give us salvation. Jesus is the winner man. When he gave up the ghost on that crucifixion Friday, as we said, now famously known as Good Friday, the debt that Jesus paid was horrible, but it was for your redemption and mine. It was for our salvation. What a wonderful God we serve. He bled and died and took our place. We should have been the one to die. Instead, Jesus did it all for me. Just for me. Jesus did it all for me. And so I am so grateful that God, my wonderful Savior, the Lamb without blemish, the sacrificial, spotless Lamb of God, took my place. And because of his sacrifice, I can have life and have it more abundantly. I have that blessed assurance in Jesus that because of his sacrifice, the place he has gone to prepare for me, I don't have to worry about this sin-sick world. I don't have to worry that if I die today, what will be my outcome. No, I have that blessed assurance that my God is able and willing to save me, to save you, to save us in spite of what we're going through because of his love for us. So that was a Good Friday. All humans are born in sin and shapen in iniquity. But the blood of Jesus, the blood that will never lose its power, that blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary on that Good Friday was shed for you and for me. Praise God for the sacrifice of His Son, Jesus Christ. Thank God that even when we were dead in sin, He, through the sacrifice on the cross of Calvary, was able and can raise us up. And so there is a great resurrection morning coming. Jesus said in John 14:1-3, "Let not your heart be troubled. If we believe in God, believe also in Him. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also." That's the supreme sacrifice that Jesus made for us. He has ascended. He has sent the Comforter to be with us and lead us and guide us. But He's coming again. Jesus is coming again. And I pray that on that great resurrection morning, that when He bursts the clouds of glory, when the Lord descend, that He will call His faithful ones to go home into eternity. That will be maybe a Good Friday. Right now, no man knoweth the hour or the day, so we have to be prepared and stay ready to receive the Lord as our Savior. This is the acceptable hour and time. Tomorrow is not promised to anyone. So I pray that we will open our hearts to God and allow Him. Let's as we rest tonight, let's reflect on that Good Friday. Let's think about the sacrifice that Jesus made for you and for me. The sacrifice that He, the blood, the whips that He took, the crown of thorns, the piercing of His side. Oh my God, how great You are. Your love surpasses anything that we can ever think or ask for. So I thank God so much for that sacrifice that He paid on that Good Friday, that we can rise again and go home into eternity out of this sin-cursed world. I pray that this message will resonate in our hearts and that we will rise again to newness of life in Christ Jesus because of that blood. So remember to plead the blood of Jesus over your children. Plead the blood of Jesus over your life every day. And that blood that will never lose its power will cover you, will cover your children, will cover your entire family. Because the enemy cannot win this battle. It is already won on that Good Friday, on that cross where Jesus sacrificed His life for you and for me. The battle was won. So don't try to fight the battle on your own. Surrender all to Jesus. Let Him take control. He cried out, "Father, not your will, but mine." Not my will, sorry, but your will be done. Let's say that to the Lord. "Father, not my will, but your will be done." Let's listen to this song. It blessed my heart. I pray that it will bless your heart. "Not my will."
Do you have to take the dearest thing that means the most to you and ask me to surrender it completely? Lord, how can I say put other things above you, you forgive me? We know the only way to live is learning how to die. 'Cause then and only then will you be Lord of my life. There's a price to pay, a death to die. There's a crown to gain, a joy to find. when I totally commit myself to you. Not my will, but thine be done. Lord, I wanna be just like the sun, unreservedly surrendered now to you. There's so many ways that I can go, but anyway from you I'd be alone. I know you know what's best, so not my will, but thine be done. If there be any other way, then take this cup away from me. 'Cause I hate the thought of walking up to Calvary. But if that's what I must do, then I'll be willing, Lord, to faithfully obey you. And the glory that awaits me when at last in you I find abandonment to selfish things and total peace of mind. Yet there's a price to pay, a death to die. There's a crown to gain, a joy to find, when all of who I am belongs to you. So not my will, but thine be done. Lord, I wanna be just like the sun, unreservedly surrendered now.
Heart. I hope it did the same for you. Not my will, Lord, but thine be done. That was what our Father did on Calvary on Good Friday. He wanted to give up, but your sins and mine kept him on the cross. That was a Good Friday. I pray that this Friday and every other Friday, we surrender totally to God. Not my will, but thine be done. I want to pray for the prayer request that we received via the email. There were several prayer requests for our children, mothers pleading for their children. There was special request for a young man who needs to be housed. He needs a home. This pandemic has caused so much distress in people's lives. A lot of folk had lost jobs, and and don't have their homes and stuff like that. So this young man is asking for prayer for God to make a way out for him to find shelter. We're going to try to find resources and put it up in the email so that you can be able to find a place for shelter. But we will pray for you and know that God will answer our prayers. Believe that he will make a way for you. And we have prayers for our young people in college that might be going through depression or discouraged because of, you know, it's the close of the school year and exams, and you know, they're requesting prayers. There is a request for a family who they're going through hardships. There's a request for a family that has been separated, and for God to make a way out for the kids to come home. So we're going to pray that whatever you're there are some unspoken prayers. God knows your hearts. And even if you don't put it in the chat or send it in, God understands. He knows your prayers. He understands tears because he was tempted in all ways like as we are. That's why he came and identified himself as a human so that he can feel what we feel. And he hears the cries of his children when we call out to him. And our prayers will not go unanswered. We just have to know that God answers it the way he knows how best to answer it for you and for me. So we are going to pray for those prayer requests right now. And then we'll go into our health tip for the evening. And then I will let you go to sleep. So at this time, let's bow our hearts, blend our spirits together, and bow our heads as we approach the throne of God. Eternal God and gracious Father, we are so thankful for another day's blessing. As we reflect on your goodness towards us throughout this day, the world over are celebrating what is called Good Friday. And we wondered what is good about that Friday. And we found so much that is good, not only good, that is great about that Friday, beyond our comprehension. We cannot, oh God, understand why, but we know that because of your love, you did what you did, died on that cross, that cruel cross for us. But we are so grateful that you did not stay on the cross, but you came down, you rested on the Sabbath, and rose again early Sunday morning. Oh God, we are so grateful that you did not stay in the grave. You have redeemed us through the precious blood of Jesus, and we are so grateful and thankful and happy for that sacrifice that you made that we can be redeemed from sin. Tonight I'm praying on behalf of my brothers and sisters. We claim your promises that if we ask believing, we will receive. You said, come. You gave us that invitation to come unto you and to lay our burdens at your feet. And that's what we're doing right now. I pray for my brother who is looking for housing. Oh God, may you provide that home for him. Not just a house, but a home where love will reign and he would be welcomed. I pray, God, that you would make a way when he cannot see with his naked eyes. You can make a way because you know the end from the beginning. So provide a home for that young man. I pray for our college students that are going through some stress, depression, or whatever is going on with them. It's the end of the school year. They have finals coming up and they have to find money. Oh God, you are the provider, redeemer, sustainer. You have made a way in the past and you will make a way for them now and in the future. So bless our young people and may they trust you. May they lean not onto their own understanding, but in all their ways acknowledge you and allow you to direct their path. We're praying for the families that were separated. The children is in one, they're in one direction and the parents are in another direction. God, you wanted the family to be united. And so we pray that you would make a way out so that these children can be reunited with their parents. Oh God, just as a mother protects her chicks from the prowler or the lion or the ravenous beast out there, that's what you do for us. You protect us from that roaring lion called Satan and the enemy and the devil. So cover us, oh God. I pray for that family in the name of Jesus, that you would work a miracle out for them so that these children can be reunited with their parents. God, I'm praying for a mom who is disturbed because her child has walked away. There's so much unspoken prayers. There's families that are going through situations. There are people that are sick because of COVID. There are people that are bereaved. They're grieving because loved ones are lost. But oh God, help us. Help us, we pray, to trust you beyond a measure that we can even think, because you are willing to do what we ask according to your will. So answer our prayers. We humbly empty ourselves from sin, and we pray, God, that you will fill us with your Holy Spirit. We're so gracious that you're still working on us. You're not done with us yet. But we ask, oh God, that you would help us to be faithful to you. Help us as we reflect this weekend on this crucifixion weekend, that we will be renewed and revived in our spirits, that we will know that God is God and God alone, and the sacrifice that he has made for us, we will see him face to face in glory. So we long for that day, and we thank you, O God, for your sacrificial gift that you give to us, free gift of salvation. May we accept it today. So touch and heal and deliver, O God, we pray, and give us the power to do what is right and pleasing in your sight, because we do not want to harbor iniquity in our hearts. We want our prayers to be answered. So answer our prayers, we ask, in the worthy name, the all-powerful name of Jesus. We pray with thanksgiving as we ask these mercies in the wonderful name of Jesus. I pray, and everyone say amen and amen. May God bless you. I look forward to seeing you on Monday evening. But before we leave, we're going to talk about the aloe vera plant. This is a plant that has hundreds of medicinal natural cures and healing powers in it. I'm going to put up on the post so you can see all the things that the aloe vera plant is good for. It's for your skin, for your hair, for your body. It is just an overall wonderful plant. And we can plant it. It's kind of like an all-season plant. You can put it in the house. You can put it in the basement. Put it out in the sun. It's an all-season plant. And it is powerful for our souls. So I will put up the post, and you will see all that the aloe vera plant is good for. Again, I thank you for fellowshipping and worshiping with me this evening, as we reflected on the goodness of God and the sacrificial lamb as we celebrate this weekend. I pray that our focus will not be on Easter bunnies and eggs, but it will be on the sacrifice that Jesus paid so you and I can be redeemed and can have salvation. It is a free gift. It's up to us to accept it. May we accept the gift of Jesus. May we be ready to receive the Lord when he returns to call us home. And he will declare, "Well done, good and faithful servants. Enter into the joys of the Lord." I want to hear those words. How about you? Have a restful night. God bless you. May you wake up and have a wonderful day tomorrow. And then we join our hearts together again on Monday, where we will enjoy another word from the Lord, some more testimonies, some more beautiful songs, and prayer one for another. As we pray, again, I pray that you will open your hearts to God and receive his blessing, because he wants to bless every one of us. I love you, but God loves you more. Good night. Good evening. Reflect on the goodness of God at bedtime. See you on Monday at 8:30 sharp. Good night.